Namaskar, welcome to UPG Pathshala. I am Shelly Duggal from the Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management, Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. Today I am going to deliver the lecture on the module Waste Disposal, that is an important topic for hotel housekeeping. At the end of the module, you will develop an understanding about the concept of waste disposal or waste management. You will learn about different types of waste and their disposal or recycling guidelines. You will also come to know about the concept of central recycling center and the role of housekeeping department in waste disposal program. So let us start. Nowadays, hotels are looking for new and innovative programs for the conservation of natural resources by reducing the waste. A few hotel organizations make environmental practices mandatory, such as water recycling, increased use of solar energy, and waste disposal program. The hotels that adopt all eco-friendly practices are called eco-tels or green hotels. The eco-tels are constructed in such a way that leads to the conservation of energy and water, adopts to efficient waste disposal program, and usage of the recycled products. Today, the hotel industry leaders evaluate their environmental policies and practices on regular basis, including recycling and waste disposal policies. Customers also want to conserve nature and loves to spend their time near it. The government has also laid down certain guidelines for promoting sustainable tourism and eco-friendly practices. As housekeeping is responsible for all kind of cleaning and maintenance of hotel premise, so waste disposal and recycling of programs should start from housekeeping department. For housekeeping, waste disposal is a daily ongoing challenge. In addition to the waste disposal or recycling cost, hotel also allocates valuable space for recycling center or waste disposal store. Most of the waste created in hotel comes from the kitchen, like cooking oil, leftover food, packaging material, food cans, bottles, broken silverware, hollowware or chinaware. Also from the housekeeping department, like cleaning and laundry chemicals, packaging, broken equipments, linen and pesticides. It comes from the front office and the other offices, like printer, cartridge, Xerox papers, cardboard waste, envelopes, brown papers. And then from the maintenance department too, machine oil, paints, electric items. An executive housekeeper must frame a recycling policy for linen and textile products, garbage reuse and recycle, and sewage treatment plant. Linen and textile products like bed sheets, towels, and curtains may be used for dusters, making the spreadsheets, swap clothes, waiter's clothes, and so on. A proper waste management for wet and dry waste must be adopted for reusing, recycling, and recovering the waste. For better understanding of waste disposal, a housekeeping personnel should have the basic knowledge of waste reduction, recycling and reusing, type of waste, waste management, environment friendly purchasing. Now, let us start with waste reduction and recycling. As this term suggests, waste reduction includes all those actions and activities that are done to reduce the amount of waste. Waste reduction includes recycling, water treatment, waste prevention, and using the products which can be reused or recycled. For reducing the waste, the first and effective method is waste prevention. Waste prevention starts with hotel purchase, as there is direct relation between hotel purchase and hotel waste. Hotels should buy environment friendly products. Those can be recycled and reused. In addition, just throwing the waste or discarded material is a loss to hotel, as it can be used for better use, like landfill, compost food can be used for the production of compost gases, solar energy that saves the electric bill, and government also gives subsidy. Treated water can be used for gardening and other purposes. There are many benefits of waste reduction, like it increases the saving by reduced purchasing cost. Waste reduction reduces waste disposal cost also. Reduction in waste reduces energy as well as the pollution. Waste reduction also promotes natural resources conservation. Let us now understand what recycling actually means. Recycling is a process in which waste material or products are used as raw material for producing a new product. Recycling prevents the combustion of useful material and put it into better use. It promotes the conservation of natural resources. In hotels, recycling programs use hotels' waste for recycling and further using of those products day-to-day operations. Recycled products can also be purchased from outside vendors at lower prices. There are so many advantages of recycling for the hotel organizations. Like, recycled products can be resold, which means generation of revenue for the hotel. Also, the waste disposal cost is reduced. It helps in conservation of natural resources. For recycling, the government subsidies can also be availed. There are different types of waste and waste disposal recycling guidelines. The housekeeping department must know about them. They must have the fundamental knowledge of waste disposal and recycling. They should have the knowledge about the type of the waste and how to process it. Let us discuss them one by one. First comes the paper cardboard. It is widely used in hotel industry, and it is the most important material to recycle. All department in hotel generates large amount of cardboard waste. Proportionately, cardboard is the largest and the easiest part in waste recycling program. As cardboard occupies large space, it should be recycled as soon as possible. Then comes office papers. Office papers are used in every department and offices of the hotel. Office papers include catalogs, magazines, letterheads, envelopes, fax papers, photocopy papers, etc. Office papers mixed with most of the papers used for recycling. The printed brochures and presentation material is also recyclable. Then newspaper waste. This is produced in tons in a hotel that provides daily papers. Newspaper preparation can be done easily by everyone which is participated. Newspapers are generally provided in bags or put on display racks, so it is easy to collect. Collect the newspapers throughout the property, placing the newspaper recycling container in various areas of hotels, such as in dining rooms, recreational areas, lounge areas, and lobbies. It is a very good idea. Then comes glass. Glasses are mainly used in food and beverage service department. Small amount of glass also is used in some other areas like guest rooms. The maximum amount of glasses is used in beer, liquor, or wine containers and service equipments. Metal. Various types of metals are also used in hotels for different purposes. Aluminium, silver, and steel are the most commonly used metals. Aluminium cans are used for the soft drink and juices. There are various kitchen equipments and containers that are also made from steel and silver. Mostly equipments used in hotels are made of metals only. Another comes plastic items. They are found in the housekeeping and food and beverage departments. Nowadays, equipments like vacuum cleaners, hard disk, etc., they contain plastics. Guests also leave plastic bags and bottles in the hotel premises. Recycling of plastic is very hard, but some plastic material can be used. Hotels should develop a standard plastic identification system based on type of plastic resins used. Originally, plastic bottles were recycled, but now manufacturers mark recycled systems on the containers that can be recycled. There are so many, like high density polyethylene and polyethylene terephthalate. They are used for heavy plastic containers used in the hotels. Then comes PET, polyethylene terephthalate. This is used for soft food containers, drink bottles and liquor bottles. Then high density polyethylene. It is normally used for manufacturing plastic bottles, for milk, water, personal care, chemicals, assorted food products, laundry detergents, etc. Then polyvinyl chloride, PVC. This is used for blister packaging. There is low density polyethylene also, which is used in making the wraps, trash bags and plastic sleeves for cups and bottles. Polypropylene, this is used for packaging containers such as shampoo bottles, yogurt containers, etc. Polystyrene, it is normally used for making cups and food trays. Polystyrene products are recyclable. Plastic products can be manufactured using a combination of various plastics I have just discussed with you. While undergoing the preparation, there are so many points which one must take care of, like check for the symbol if the container is recyclable or not. Empty the food container or any plastic product and clean out the residue. We should also know that certain items are not accepted as food trays, milk bags, soft drink bags, connector tubes, polythene covers and flower pots. There are some other recyclable products too, like furniture. Refinishing or re-upholstered furniture can be used or it can be sold to another hotels, home decoration employees, or can be donated to charitable trust also. Then there are equipments also. Either repair the quality equipments which can be used again instead of purchasing the new ones. Old equipments, they can, or their parts, they can be used for repairing some other equipments. Old equipments can also be traded while purchasing the new equipments. Instead of throwing the useless equipments, give them to some vocational schools where they can be used in teaching the students. Keep all the equipments out of the main waste stream. Then comes construction debris. It includes the waste produced or created during construction or repairing. All construction materials should be kept out of main waste stream. Windows, doors, fittings, locking systems and lumbers can be reused or recycled. Then there is landscape waste also, which is produced in the lawns and gardens that are maintained by the hotel. Hotels should have a landscape recycling program for managing landscape waste. Hire some specialist or use latest techniques to save the water and provide suitable climate and soil for the growth of plants and other shrubs maintained by the hotel. The waste is also in the form of cooking oil and grease, which is used in food and beverage production department. The used stained oil should be collected instead of throwing away. Hotel can make contract with the companies that recycle the cooking oil and grease. There is motor oil also present in the maintenance department. Hotels can also ask the oil supplier for setting up a motor oil recycling center. Now let us know about the central recycling center, which is called as CRC. The area outside the main premises of a hotel used for recycled materials and products is called central recycling center. In large hotel, it may be located near to docking area or receiving area. Most preferred locations for CRC is near to employee service entry and exit. There must be easy access to the containers and picking of vehicles. The reason for making CRC outside the main premises is the amount of space required for waste disposal containers, and other reasons are like odors, rodents, insects, etc. The location of CRC also depends on hotel design and the space available. CRC visibility is also a concern for hotels as it creates an unattractive and undesirable appearance for the guests due to wastage containers and recycling equipments. However, increased awareness among the guests for environment creates a positive image for recycling and waste disposal programs. Equipments are needed in CRC for the storage and material preparation for recycling. In CRC, one can find different types of containers with different colors representing the type of waste. Mostly used containers are recycling roll of containers, dumpsters, and portable large containers. Roll of containers, they are large recycling containers and can be compartmentalized for different types of waste, or simply a single container can be used instead of putting number of containers for all kind of waste. These are usually closed on the top and have a door at conventional height with locking system. Roll of containers can be purchased through manufacturers, and even hotel can modify it according to requirements. Dumpsters are also like containers but of small size as compared to roll of containers. These are commonly used in smaller properties like motels, small hotels for waste storage. Large hotels can use dumpsters for storing specific materials such as cardboards, papers, newspapers, and plastic separately. However, small size of dumpsters make them unsuitable for large hotels as it would require more frequent emptying, which would increase the cost. Dumpsters are emptied on the back of disposal truck, and these are not allowed to take outside the hotel premises. Dumpsters are painted on the basis of the recycled material and the capacity of the container. In CRC, portable containers are usually of 92 gallon size and used for collecting and storing the waste material. These are suitable for smaller hotels that recycle only few items such as newspapers and office papers. Portable containers may be used by large hotels for specific storage of recycled waste. One must also consider that the containers used for recycling should have colors based on the type of waste. For roll of containers, hotel can blend with hotel's color scheme also. Then, repairs should be done as soon as there is some hole in the containers. Containers must be checked for repairing and maintenance on regular basis. One must ensure that the cleaning of the containers should be done on regular basis to reduce the odor. In summers, cleaning cycles should be reduced. Cleaning should be done outdoor. The hotel name must be painted on the container with capacity of the container. Collection and pull-off schedule should be followed, and on-call pick should be available in case of emergency. For leasing recycling containers, short-term contract, usually 3 to 6 months, should be signed with the contract cancellation clause for terminating the services if found unsatisfactory. Students, housekeeping department plays significant role in waste disposal program. Waste disposal helps housekeeping in reducing the volume of waste and toxicity waste generated in a hotel. Housekeeping department contributes a lot in waste disposal. Housekeeping executive must conduct a separate department audit to identify the type of waste generated from each department and make a list of recyclable and non-recyclable items. Waste disposal can be planned or started by targeting the specific material which produce waste in larger amount. Then establish a short-term and long-term waste disposal policy and implement suitable waste reduction strategies. The housekeeping guidelines for waste disposal and waste reduction are waste reduction programs in housekeeping. Housekeeping department changes bed linen on daily basis, even for a same guest, without any stains on bed linen. Hotels can make a policy for laundering the bed linen once in 2 or 3 days for same guest until there are no stains on the bed sheets. This practice would be very helpful in saving a large amount of water. Instead of throwing leftover shampoo, soaps, conditioners, use refillable bottles in guest rooms and refill them. Tissues, they should be replaced in bathrooms when they are almost empty. A hotel can draft a policy of leaving new toilet rolls or tissue boxes for the guest to replace. If hotel policy does not allow using below half toilet rolls, use them in employees' restrooms and toilets or donate to shelters. An employee should switch off lights, fans and other electric appliances when not in use. Ensure that the drapes are closed properly to maximize the effect of air conditioner in guest rooms. Housekeeping personnel should report immediately about any leak or fault that is observed in fittings. Housekeeping department should use biodegradable cleaning agents in all the cleaning processes. In laundry, use of biodegradable cleaning agents promotes eco-friendly practices. All recyclable waste should be collected separately and recycled. Make a contract to the vendors who recycle the products. Eliminate the use of plastic bags and sticker used in housekeeping. Reuse the discarded linen in other areas, like use of bed sheets, towels in making dusters and spreadsheets, or use them in employees' restrooms. Use the dump plastic drums and buckets for collecting recycling items or trashes in recycle centers. Use the recyclable packaging in packing of equipments and other items used in housekeeping. Worn mattresses, they can be manufactured, so do not throw them. Nowadays, many mattress manufacturers buy the old mattresses and replace with new one with some extra cost. Maximize the use of disposal and reusable bags. Promote the use of pump style spray cans instead of arsenal sprays. Use of digital and electronic services minimizes the use of papers. Executive housekeepers should encourage the staff to follow eco-friendly practices and arrange such kind of training sessions and seminars. Then there should be a reduction in the usage of the toxic products. Arrange the training seminars for guiding the housekeeping employees on use of chemicals and their hazardous effects. Purchase cleaning agents or other chemicals with less hazardous constituents. Do the labeling of all chemicals properly with the right title. Chemical containers should be checked periodically for leakage and spills. Chemical store should be cool, dry and well ventilated. Use the cautions that are mentioned on the label and read the instructions carefully before starting use. Battery recycling area should be used for dead cell, rechargeable batteries and other batteries. Remove the food containers. Use recycling containers. Remove any spills and crimps. And regular cleaning of area reduce the need of pesticides. Support the eco-friendly practices like refillable dispensers should be used for all liquid hair and care products and buy bathroom supplies in bulk. Recyclable items should be bought and used. Recyclable paper, it can be used for guest stationery. All guest room supplies placed in guest rooms and chemicals used for the cleaning should be biodegradable. Hand dryers, they can be used instead of tissue box in restrooms. Donating the hotel leftover or damaged items like furniture, mattresses and other amenities to charities. Promote the use of reusable or recyclable mugs and cups for in-room services, and non-disposable products can be used. So dear students, we have learned that the waste material disposal or waste management includes all those activities or actions needed from its origin to its disposal. Waste management also includes all those activities undertaken to make those items reusable. Housekeeping plays an important role in waste disposal, as most of the work related to cleaning and maintenance are taken care of by the housekeeping department. It is a responsibility of an executive housekeeper to develop a framework for waste management. Housekeeping employees should have a fundamental knowledge on waste disposal and recycling of different kinds of products and materials. Detailed guidelines for waste disposal and recycling are discussed just now. A central recycling center can be operated by hotel or may be outsourced for disposing the waste. This chapter deals with the waste disposal and waste reduction activities followed in the housekeeping department. Housekeeping can play a major role in waste management by reducing the waste. Waste reduction can be promoted by awareness and reusing the products and linen, such as discarded linen. It can be used for making dusters and spreadsheets. Promote the purchase of recyclable products and equipments. Increase the use of soap dispensers and eliminate the use of non-biodegradable chemicals and cleaning agents. Waste management and reduction is not only the responsibility of the housekeeping. It is the duty of the hotels and the guests also staying there. Hotels should educate the employees for eco-friendly practices and conduct regular sessions for bringing innovative ideas to manage and reuse of waste for better purpose instead of disposing. Thank you very much.